You'll have to wait and see.
Siesta Key.
Siesta Key.
Season 8.
I mean, you see what happened. You see what happened on the show, but it was, I think it was just very fast and sudden and passionate, and then it kind of like got
fizzled.
We were crashed. Like on this high, and reality kind of set in, and we realized like just like all the struggles around us, and it was just a lot.
The outside distractions were tough.
Yeah.
Totally.
Yeah.
You guys were living on a high, they were talking on a low.
Right.
Yeah. Yeah. Us against the world.
And when you're like a rap song.
Well, when you guys were traveling, everything was like great.
When we weren't around everyone else.
And then everyone gets involved in your relationship.
Yeah. It's crazy how different those two were.
Yeah.
But you guys seem like you're on good terms now, sitting next to each other.
Fine.
Could we see maybe a rekindling or what?
Maybe. You'll have to wait and see. Yeah.
Siesta Key.
Siesta Key.
Season 8. Season 8.
Right now we're great. We have had a lot of ups and downs though. And I actually am shocked that we're even still friends, but we made it somehow. She's very loyal when she wants to be, and I think she's starting to realize what she actually values in a friend and like who she wants to be surrounded by. So it's me. She wants to be surrounded by people like me. I think we'll see.
It's power.
She likes
strategic. It always is. It's how Chloe is.
Sure. But she's been a great friend to me recently. So, not right now. I don't know. I hear she hates him one day, and then the next day they're friends. So, but they've been not friends for quite a while now. So,
Think she was initially friends with him in spite of you?
I think he was initially friends with her in spite of me.
For me being single this season, it's been fun, honestly. I think I've enjoyed myself.
Messy cozy.
Not messy. I'm like not in a relationship then, like in the beginning of the season, and so to finally be single and not be in a relationship on the show was kind of nice and refreshing. And I didn't have everyone involved in my relationship, and I wasn't dealing with what you guys were dealing with.
Right.
And so, I don't know, I enjoyed the summer.
Yeah.
But then I also do have my moments as the season progresses. Oh, I hate her.
Yeah.
I hate Kara. That's point blank.
You guys, there's no type of like, trying
to. No, I have no reason to be friends with that girl. Oh, I think watching Garrett and Kara try to make things work. It was just kind of like I know him and I could see how he was around her, and I know he cares a lot for her, but also he's not himself around her and isn't showing his personality, and she's very like.
She would make him mean.
Yeah, and she would tell him like not to hang out with me and everything, and like I understand like not hanging out with an ex, I completely understand that, but even just like in group settings, like not being around me kind of just rubbed me wrong.
I mean, that makes sense, but she was also just like, she was a brat and she made him not nice.
Yeah, she controlled him, and that's just.
He was always in a bad mood.
Yeah.
And it was just annoying.
It was very toxic.